Welcome to lecture 1, Introduction to Mechatronics. In this video, we are going to cover the following topics: definition of mechatronics, role of mechatronics engineer, need for mechatronics, classification of mechatronic systems, emerging areas of mechatronics, advantages, disadvantages, and applications of mechatronics. What is mechatronics? Mechatronics is an interdisciplinary field that can be defined as the synergistic integration of mechanical, electrical, and electronic control system for designing of processes and products. So by the term synergistic, what we mean is all these three fields, mechanical, electrical, and electronic field, they cooperate and work in such a way that they produce an output which is far better than the output that could be produced by them if they work individually. So mechatronics, the word mechatronics is a combination of mechanical and electronics. This is the graphical representation of mechatronics. The word mechatronics was coined by a Japanese engineer, Yasakawa, in the late 1960s. This word was coined as a response to the increasing thirst for automation in industries and elsewhere. So mechatronics involves the following branches of engineering, like mechanical engineering, electrical engineering, electronics engineering, computer engineering, and control engineering. So mechanical systems include hydraulic, pneumatic, rotational, translational, thermal, etc. These systems are employed in mechatronic applications. These systems are interfaced with computers through sensors, actuators, and electronic systems. So other mechanical components which are used are control valves, gears, cylinders, chain, etc. Next is electrical system. So electrical system are concerned with the behavior of current and voltage, like electrical motors, generators, transformers, relays, circuit breakers, switches, etc. are the electronic components mostly used in the mechatronic system. Electronic system, these systems are used to transduce information between the computer world and the mechanical disciplines. So in mechatronic system, the electronic devices are used to design circuits like analog circuit, digital circuit, etc. Microprocessor and microcontroller based systems are most widely used in the mechatronic systems. So computer systems, it's a combination of hardware and software, and they are useful in product design, process planning and control, flexible manufacturing, online quality monitoring, etc. Control system, it involves a representation of systems, their behavior, and modifications in the system behavior. So it includes components such as stepper motors, synchros, AC and DC position control, servo motors, servo mechanisms, actuator, etc. So we will see about all these components in detail in the coming chapters. What is the role of a mechatronics engineer? A mechatronics engineer should be able to design and select mechanical devices required for that application, sensors and actuator. He should be able to design the analog and digital circuits for the application, and he should know about the control devices to design the modern system. Why there is a need for mechatronics? Changing market conditions. So in today's world, the market scenario is so volatile that a product which is introduced today may become outdated tomorrow. In order to attract the customers, it is a duty of the company to adapt to the changes in the market. So this could be achieved only by implementing mechatronic systems in the production line. Need for variety in a product. Now the customers demand variety in shape, size, color, dimension, features, aesthetics of a single product. The best example is a mobile phone. We all don't have a same mobile phone. We have different models. Even in the same model, we have different colors, etc. So mechatronics is the only solution to meet these demand. Demand for high quality products. So to make the product reach the customers, quality of the product is the key factor. With the help of mechatronics, the product quality can be ensured. Flexibility. So flexibility means the ease with which a particular facility can be reconfigured. So with mechatronics, it is just easy to reconfigure a process done by a particular machine. Intelligent process control. So with implementation of mechatronics, centralized decision making is possible. So this makes the process control smart and easier. Enhanced product design. With the introduction of software in the company, it is possible to check a particular design for failure. We need not actually manufacture the product. We can just design it in the software and we can do analysis and we can say whether it will fail or not. So a design can be accepted or rejected based on the simulation results itself without actually manufacturing the product. Reliable inspection of products. So automatic inspection is always better than the manual inspection. So with mechatronics, automation in the inspection line is possible, and with improved inspection techniques, the manufacturer can ensure that only best product reaches the customer. Increase in production rate. So though good quality products are produced, it is necessary to make sure that the product reaches the customer on time. With the implementation of mechatronics in the production line, the rate of production can be increased. Classification of mechatronic system. So initially the mechatronic products were classified by JSPMI, that means Japanese Society for the Promotion of Machine Industry. They have classified mechatronic system into four classes. Class 1 is a basic mechanical product with little amount of electronics incorporated into it. The best example is a numerical controlled machine. Class 2, they are traditional mechatronic system with some more electronics integrated into it. Example is a modern sewing machine. So it does the regular function, but instead of operating it manually, we have motors to operate the sewing machine. Class 3, it holds the function of a traditional system, but all the internal components are replaced by electronics. They have removed the mechanical components and they have replaced it with electronic. The best example is digital watch. And class 4 is the highly advanced mechatronic products. So they are designed with integration of mechanical and electronic technologies. Examples are microwave ovens, photocopying machines, etc. come under class 4. What are the emerging areas of mechatronics? We will list some of the emerging areas of mechatronics. Machine vision. Machine vision uses your image processing for analysis purpose or for getting the output. Robotics, home and industrial automation, unmanned vehicles, computer integrated manufacturing, virtual reality, automotive industries, medical field. So these are the emerging areas of mechatronics. What are the advantages of mechatronics? So we have already seen that mechatronic systems are highly flexible. In order to produce a new product, we need not change the entire configuration of the machine. Instead, we can just change a program to alter the design in the product. And the product produced using mechatronic systems are of very good quality, and these systems are more reliable than the pure traditional mechanical systems. And they result in greater productivity and enhanced functionality. Some of the disadvantages of mechatronics are: the initial cost of the mechatronics products is high. In order to design and implement a mechatronic system, the person should have knowledge in various disciplines. One has to be highly skilled to design and implement the mechatronic system. Incorporating mechatronics approach in already existing system becomes a little complex and expensive. Some of the applications of mechatronic systems include domestic products like washing machine, microwave ovens, refrigerator, air conditioning units, vacuum cleaners, digital cameras, etc. Office equipments such as printers, photocopying machine, scanners, fax machines, etc. Retail equipment such as your barcode scanners. Industrial systems such as pick and place robot, your CNC machines, automated guided vehicles, etc. With this, lecture 1 is over. So in the next lecture, we will see about systems. Thank you.